everyone. Welcome to this episode of Context is King. I'm Rebecca Brayton, and with me as always is WatchMojo founder and CEO Ashkan Karbasfrooshan to discuss coronavirus, because is there anything else to talk about? Not really. So, Ash, what is coronavirus's impact going to be on business and media advertising?
Well, we've never experienced like this, anything like this, and I don't think anybody had a global pandemic as a risk factor going into the new year. So
the creators of the movie Contagion might have.
They did, but did they think it would happen now, 2020, 20 years after Y2K? Look, the reality is if people were honest, they would admit that much of the uncertainty and the anxiety does stem from, like, what's the economic impact, right? Because by and large, unless you're old, if you have some social distancing, you know, if you kind of wash your hands and you do a lot of things that people should have been doing all along, hopefully it doesn't really affect most people, even though I think this is going to become a thing, that a lot of people are going to get infected, be exposed to it.
Well, they're estimating, I mean, I keep seeing different estimates, yeah, but they're estimating between 30 and 70% of people are going to contract it.
And, you know, one of the few times that we will actually timestamp this, so this is being recorded March 12th in case...
Happy birthday.
Thank you. yay. So we'll try to get this out sooner than we usually do. But yeah, so the numbers are going to change. It's a fluid situation. But fear is actually temporary, but greed is permanent, right? So my guess is that the same way that people freaked out maybe about AIDS or drinking or smoking or drinking and driving, HPV and all these things that kind of capture people's imaginations, drive them crazy, but then a few months or years or quarters, depending on the severity and the newness of it, they get very desensitized about it, right? So I personally, you seem to disagree.
No, I was trying to figure out what word.
Yeah, they won't care about it as much.
Right.
They won't be as sensitive to it.
And desensitized?
That's okay. The word, yeah. You are sorry. Putting the right emphasis on the right syllable. No, that's it. I was clearly not nailing it. So I do think it's going to be part of our new normal. I don't want to definitely, like, Trump is crazy. This is what happens when you elect incompetent jackasses. But I do think, though, that it will be something that people get. Now, we don't know the severity. It'll mutate. There'll be vaccines. It'll take a lot of time. But if we're talking about the impact on the media industry, the impact on advertising and whatnot, look, I think you are going to see some industries get annihilated. I think
TV is about to have a very good period.
Well, that's it, right? I mean, if you think of, like, if you are in a travel industry, you're decimated. If you're like an airline, you're destroyed, right? If you're a hotel, forget it. Airbnb went from being a sexy thing to,
oh my God,
like,
just,
like, nobody's going to go into an Airbnb because Airbnb, nobody cleans it, right? Whereas, so that industry kaput, and people are like comparing it to 9/11. It's nothing like 9/11. 9/11 happened and it was like, you know, you knew the U.S. was going to go bomb some countries that had nothing to do with it. This is going to linger for a while, and some companies are not going to be unscathed. Now, the problem is the spillover, because you got two parts. You got the uncertainty, and you got the eventual recession. And anybody that's like, is this the end of the bull run? Yeah, idiots, it's the end of the bull run. And that's normal. Any investor and any entrepreneur that thinks that everything just grows and goes to the right is a idiot, excuse my language. You have cycles. It just so happens the shock to the system was much more profound. So if you look at movies like James Bond, if you look at movies like Fast and the Furious that are being delayed, some of it could be underlying production delays that are then causing the distribution to be delayed. I think for the big tentpole...
I mean, they also just think it's irresponsible for people to go to see the movies.
I wish it was the altruism.
Well, yeah, okay, fine.
I think for a movie like James Bond...
And also, they're not going to make as much money.
There you go. Yeah. Like, these are big movies that need to blow up in China. Obviously, China, which is actually recovering relatively well because they just went to extreme, and we'll cover that in a follow-up video. But it doesn't make sense for them to release that and kind of lose out on these big markets. So what it's going to happen, though, is if people stay home, people are more hesitant to go sit in a movie theater with others. And statistics show that at least as of now, year over year, theatrical attendance has stayed constant. But you are going to see a psychological effect. And a lot of movie, I think there's some theaters that are just going to shut down. Initially in areas like Seattle that are, or New York, where it's really dense and people are like, this makes no sense. I'm not sure if it'll be nationwide, and we'll talk about that in the next clip. But yes, I do think that TV is going to do really well. Streaming services are going to do really well. Netflix, YouTube, HBO, Disney+, even Quibi.
That is if you can get to work to create content for your YouTube channel.
Well, that's the thing, right? I mean, but then again, you have a lot of legacy content and classics. Look, ultimately, if you are in travel, you're going to get annihilated. But even if you are in automotive or you are in consumer electronics and there's a part in your device, hardware, that comes from a plant in China, you don't have that plant, you don't have that piece from the plant. You're not going to put it in your product. And advertising, unfortunately, is a variable cost that is very easy to scale back. And I think that's what you're going to see. Everybody will take a hit, some more than others. And then so the first part is the uncertainty. People don't know the impact, the full impact. So that is actually much worse than the second part, which is the recession. There will be a recession, and I think that's going to suck. But that's part of the economic cycle. I almost want to get to that part because then you know, hey, we got to cut costs by 20%. Hey, you got to, you know, maybe order less parts because there's less demand. I think right now is this just fear and uncertainty that is just sending people into hysteria. Do you have enough toilet paper? Like, what's up with that, by the way? You know, why are people stocking
up? If you have to be stuck in your house for a month or
Amazon,
14
Amazon, deliver me toilet paper,
yeah, but
Alexa.
The Amazon guy should be self-quarantining at that point. Yeah. You know what I mean?
No, I get it. I get it. Anyway.
Only bought like two packages. Don't worry.
Okay, good. So too much info. No, I'm kidding. So I do think it's going to be, obviously not saying anything crazy here. I think we just want to get over the uncertainty phase to get to the recession, to wrap our arms around it so then you could kind of get back to business.
So how do you think coronavirus is going to impact your business or industry? Let us know in the comments and we will see you next time.